third, so it's not even like he was. Yeah, it's
master, right? Because Ty, or excuse me, oh, they're going to try and jump on a Pai Lai Dai here. Pai jumps just a little bit too close, and they instantly grab him. That's going to be your first blood for Captain AU.
That bottom lane. Oh, the arrow hits to a creep.
Oh, Cuckoo. He might be able to get away because of it. Nope, that Starstorm's going to be not back over the top lane where we have the Primal Roar. Snake King, though, is still going to be gone on as Gabby and Tim show up. Watching that newbie LGD game, he had a pretty good Sven game.
I can't believe we have a family that's... No, how's the X-Boat
pulled back onto the Snake King. Can they actually burst him down fast enough before he gets any spells off? And it looks like the Sonic Wave going to be used to finish him off before the Primal Roar comes out. Yawar will take that kill onto the Rubick, but Armel snatches the Bounty Rune away from him. The board's going to be able to slow him down. Armel needs a lot of time for this Blink to come back up. Can Cuckoo save him? The Telekinesis, the arrow's going to land. Starstorm's out. Fairy Fire's not good enough, nor is the bottle hit. CC and C will... Moonlight Shadow will find an opening. Tims, who's been defending this mid tower with Fatebolt after Fatebolt. There's still several TNT members, and OD, he just blinked into that one, but they don't have the burst damage to be able to deal with him right away. The Ice Blast is coming in. Is it actually going to hit anything? It doesn't. The Imprisonment will protect him against the X as well. Newbie have made a pretty clean get out of free here. Pai Lai Dai, well, that's just kind of expected of RML. He's got a Yule Scepter. He needs to be able to use it now and blink away, but he can't actually get it off. He's been stunned for too long.
I just prefer getting Deso with BKB.
Gabby, you might have to use your BKB right now. Pai Lai Dai is so tanky because of the extra armor. Even with the double damage, Gabby's a little bit surprised by that one, but thanks to the blur, he's actually pretty tough to be able to bring down the arrow. Can he come fast enough? It does! The BKB doesn't last long enough. Can TNC come into this one? Because they actually took down CC&C during that timing. But you are. He's pretty tough to be able to fight. They do have the imprisonment on Tim. He's going to imprison himself during this open wounds. He has a telekinesis ready to go. Can he actually use it? The arrow's going to be blocked in by Cuckoo. Soaks that one up for his team. The cold feet actually locking down the lifestealer. Yawar falls, and Cuckoo looks for an extra X kill. As I was talking at you, but we have Gabby quickly eliminating Pai Lai Dai. The Moonlight Shadow's going out. They're going to try and chain stun it, and they just quickly take him out.
Jesus.
The Sanity's Eclipse against an Agility hero. I think you lose so much momentum when you lose your PA.
Yes. I mean, your PA is the majority of your damage with the way that the rest of your cores have decided to itemize.
Yeah. Because once the PA is dead, like, newbie can be super fearless in everything they do. They can take Roshan, they can force any fights they want, they can spread out and farm a lot if they want to. And Now they're just getting picked up one after one. I'm not sure if AU had the right idea there, but now he's may have caught Timson in trouble, but thankfully the rage he stole earlier is going to buy him a little bit of time. The toss back is going to slow down some of these heroes. The torrent does land on two, but Tims is still dead.
Dude, some of these arrows
going to go in. He does have the Sonic Wave, but that's not enough to be able to finish off Snake King.
He had a BKB for that cap.
He did.
The main hero he plays.
Yeah.
Oh, they're going to walk in.
AU, he's going to be spotted here. Glimmer Cape trying to get rid of the vision. The newbie has, but a boar and a hawk can still get him. They're going to turn. Oh my god. Not again. Dude, they just committed so much to be able to kill Pai Lai Dai. He's still alive. The torrent's finally going to be able to finish him up. But guess what? Armel got too close. He sized
like
the feist up.
Fourth time.
Like, how many times do you fall into the trap?
Is that the fifth time they've done that? Pai Lai Dai has one for some reason.
Why does Pai have one?
I have no idea. As top lane? Maybe a fight here as they're going to go again on this PA. The Roar instantly blown up.
The Sanity's Eclipse against this Agility hero. It's all you need.
And the Banish was spamming
it. Oh, and the BKB wears out. They get the Imprisonment to stop Cuckoo.
The arrow follow-up.
And they have a buyback on Gabby, but they don't have one on Cuckoo. Now AU's in trouble. There's the Ethereal Blade from MSS with the Aghanim Starstorm.
It looks like it at this point. As a basher's now completed on Yuar, who has an MKB, so the effectiveness of that PA gonna die down a lot more.
They finally get the jump! They do manage to bring down CC&C. Armel gets in with the Sonic Wave and the Ice Blast over the top. Yuar's actually gonna get Telekinesis as well, won't be able to get an invest inside anybody, so he's gonna lose his Aegis here. How is his team gonna bail him out? They don't have Primal Roar, they do have Freezing Field, though, that's one ability. Yuar with the Rage, TNC.
Oh, Pai Lai Dai. Oh, poor Pai.
Gonna go for Pylite. And the arrow hits! It nails Armel, but Yoar, can he commit to this? The Ethereal Blade, the Glimmer Cape's gonna be able to protect him from a lot of that magic damage. The Primal Roar onto Gabby. MSS trying to get away from that big carry. Armel,
the arrow
is helping out. Gabby hitting with the arrow as well. He does have the dagger, bashing up the Lifestealer. That's gonna be able to keep him away from Yoar. Jumps over to AU, so he will survive here, but still. Hero's getting lower and lower. The Yule Scepter preventing their retreat. The TP in from MSS with the Boots of Travel, scaring back the rest of TNC. Or maybe it's Tim's. They get close inside the base. Inside the device initiation, Tim's is already dead. He does have buyback. Cuckoo teleporting in pretty aggressively. Pylite Die is going to be the initiation, but there's the imprisonment. The Ice Blast used once again to try and kill that Crystal Maiden. They do have the CCNC locked down. The Andes is going to be able to protect them. There goes the Primal Roar on that double damage PA. The DB is going to wear out now, and so is the BKB. And he's still
so much damage.
Eclipse. It almost one-shots the PA, cleaned up by Yoar, and that's it. She's dead for 2 minutes, a minute and a half on Armel's Queen of Pain. And honestly, I think Armel might just be happy that his suffering is over.
He's like, I am done with this game. Let's reset. This was...
I mean, this was the slowest, most grinding loss we've had so far.
Yes.
Juggernaut.
It is Jug. I mean, you're not going to beat the Jug in lane anyway, so what's the point of it, right?
They're going to be able to pull him in, get the Burrow Strike kill onto Snake King as he runs into another Bramble. That actually got him killed, I think. First Blood goes to Cuckoo. Try and quickly address that Siege Wagon. Cuckoo is going to be gone on those CCNC. They want to be able to root out this Sand King. They have the sentry laid out into the trees. Cuckoo's trying to find it right now, but won't be able to get there in time. Vlad's all ready for AU. This is a really farm Chen. He's actually going to turn and fight CCNC. Oh, God, he's losing this fight. Fortunately, he doesn't get hit by the Burrow Strike, but he is still controlled up enough that he dies. Showing up at the bottom lane, but all of Newbie are going to come in and try and defend the safe lane tower. The stun going out.
Oh, look at the stun. He's getting
so
ripped
much
apart.
Damage from this pure damage. The impetus is too much for him to handle. Now, Armel, he's maybe feeling that mid-game against an Ember Spirit. Fortunately, Cuckoo was there to be able to bail him out. This Newbie lineup is CCNC. He's going to try. Oh, he gets Bro Struck. LSA kind of chaining that one a little bit, but it doesn't matter. They have more than enough damage. That's his weakness. That's his kryptonite. It's all that pure damage. It's going to get chained up, snaking,
really
not even targeting Gabby.
Tower?
They want to be able to finish off the tower. They have the
Here
epicenter
the
initiation with a Burrow Strike. That's going to be a lot of damage on the CCNC and Luke into play. It's going to be enough to finish him off. Cuckoo, he will die in return. The Omni Slash bouncing in, RP being attempted. Now used as MSS locks down the Sven and lets his team be able to get away. Tim's does the same with the Terrorize.
Oh, it's going to catch
Snaking,
though.
But it's going to be able to catch Snaking. Thanks to that, Armel is going to start laying out some damage with the double damage. But Snaking, he wakes up fast enough to be able to get a little bit of distance away from Tim's. Only half the damage from that Bedlam goes out. The Yule Scepter and LSA miss. Another stun coming in. He's actually so tanky with the combination of miss spells.
He's going to beat him back.
Chain stuns. He's fine.
He's actually going to beat him back. And another stun by Armel, who's hit like 4 in a row now, but...
They want her to sit in the back line. They need that distance, but he just keeps
taking
shots. Newbie, the rest of the team is going to be here. They have the RP, the Omni Slash on top of the Sven as well, but they're so tanky, they are going to be able to split that damage pretty nicely. And Gabby with God Strength and a BKB, there's going to be buyback from both the Snaking as well as CCNC, but bye-bye, Pylite Die. Now Gabby going to be chased by CCNC, will be able to hit him with the chains, but can man fight him? Just has to slow him down and let Snaking do the real damage.
I feel like they should be a little bit reluctant here. But it looks like they're going to go for it anyways as the Sanky
just
going to lay it
a
out.
A bold sandstorm, and then Burrow Strikes to the other side of the cliff, so they can't really stop him.
Oh.
And they're going to have to choose to fight for this Roshan underneath the sandstorm, constantly taking this damage. And the Healing Ward, he's actually going to wear out. So no, the damage is going to be consistent. But Cuckoo's very low on this side here. He's going to Burrow Strike back in. Can he actually
Who's got it?
He gets it. Cuckoo! He steals the Aegis. And now, are they going to be able to get out of two-man LSA?
Oh.
Cuckoo's back in.
Ember's
another round of sandstorm.
Again.
Look at this, Magnus. He's dead as well. And Yoar had to just leave the fight. He's been caught by the Bedlam. He's gonna mant up a Cuckoo, catches them again with the epicenter. Cuckoo comes in clutch. Significantly tankier. Seeing that be a problem for them, he's gonna make the initiation onto the Enchanters immediately. Laguna Blade, Shivas, and just tons of burst damage. Oh, what an RP. Gabby, though, is still alive. The Omni Slash can actually do enough, though. They're so tanky. Cuckoo, who took most of the Omni Slashes, doesn't even come close to death between the 10 armor, the Guardian Greaves, and the Chen heals. It's too much. CCNC will try and drag him away, but the double damage Gabby overwhelms him. And that is going to be the game.
That was a funny death. He's just like, you know what? Add one to the list. As he's going to go for it again.
No buybacks of many of these heroes. A fast initiation on CCNC with the Terrorize. Follow up the stun, spin. That's good enough. CCNC, how many deaths is that, Scriff? GG. Nine deaths. Nine deaths in 35 minutes.
And he probably cost them the potential comeback Roche, right?
That man